Hey guys, Tom here at Raycom TV. Hope you're all doing really well. Welcome back to the studio for another episode of our Raycom short series. Now, I've got my hands on an MCR54 because I'd like to chat you guys through the various options we have available to us with outputs and bases. So the MCR54 is such a versatile product, in partly thanks due to this selection of bases and outputs. So let's take a little look through, starting with our top feed on the front here. We have a TA5M connector that can output both analog and digital outputs. We have two electronically balanced analog outputs or four AES3 digital outputs. Let's move on then to our bases, starting with the BPA54. Let's take a little look. So the BPA54 is the standard MCR54 rear panel. On here we have two TA5M outputs and the high-rose power connector if you did want to have external fixed power. So from those TA5M outputs, we can have four digital AES or four analog channels. And if you have disabled AES or only have it enabled for the top feed, then you can have any combination of receivers for those two analog outputs. That's the BPA54. Let's move on to the SLK54-IK. So this is super slot and uni slot compatible. Let's take a little look again. So the SLK54 includes a flange as well, as it is for slotting formats, and you have both analog and AES outputs, AES outputs being possible both from the top feed and the base itself as well. So you can have four outputs on the base, but only when you've enabled AES3 for that base. You do that in the MCR54 settings. However, when AES is disabled or only enabled for the top feed, then your analog base outputs can be configured with any combination of receivers you choose. That's the SLK54-IK. Let's move on to the SLK54-SX. Let's have a little look at the features it offers. So the SLK54-SX is for slotting use with Sony cameras and again has a flange included as it is for slotting use. You can have two analog outputs on the base and you can choose which receivers to use. And this is due to the fact that it's used with Sony cameras which only accept two analog signals. So with the SLK54-SX, if you did want AES digital outputs, you'll only be able to get those from that top feed on the front of the MCR54 itself. So guys, those are the varying bases and outputs available to us. Hopefully you found this video helpful. If you have any more queries at all about this, either let us know down in the comments or just get in touch. We'd love to hear from you. All our contact details will be in the video description. Take care guys, we'll see you soon.